Hi everybody, I am going to discuss assembler part 1. In this video, I am going to discuss the purpose of part 1, databases of part 1 and the flowchart of assembler part 1 and the flowchart of assembler part 1. So first of all, part 1. It defines the purpose of the part 1. It defines symbols and literals. It defines symbol and literals and remember them in symbol table. Remember them in symbol table and literal table respectively. So the purpose of part 1 is to define the symbol. It is used to define the symbol in the and the literals and remember them in the symbol table and literal table respectively. Remember them in the symbol table and literal table respectively. So this is the purpose of part 1 and it is used to keep track of location counter. It is used to keep track of location counter. It is used to update the location counter. Location counter is updated every time line is scanned by the assembler. One line is scanned by the assembler, so it is automatically updated. It is used to keep track the LC. Next is third one. It processes the pseudo operation. It processes the pseudo operation. So these are the tasks of part 1. It defines the symbol and literals and remember them in symbol table and literal tables respectively. It is used to keep track of location counter. It processes the pseudo operation. So this is the main purpose of part 1. Part 1 is also called as analysis phase. Analysis and part 2 is known as synthesis phase. So this is the purpose of part 1 assembler. Now the databases of part 1. During the part 1, we need the following databases that are used to help the part 1. Number 1. First database is input the source code. Input the source program. This one is the first database. Number 2. A location counter that is used to keep track. A location counter LC used to keep track of each instruction. So this is the second database. Location counter. Next, a table, MOT, machine operation table that indicate a table, machine operation table that indicates the symbolic numeric for each instruction and its corresponding length. A table MOT that indicate the symbolic numeric for each instruction and its corresponding length. So this is the purpose of the databases pass one. These are the databases. Number 4, a table POT. POT mean pseudo operation table. Indicate the symbolic numeric and the action to be taken for each pseudo opcode in pass 1. these are the database. These are the databases. Number one, input the source program. Number two, location counter used to keep track of each instruction. Number three, a table MOT that indicate the symbolic numeric for each instruction. Table that indicate the symbolic numeric of each instruction and its corresponding value. The third one is a POT, pseudo operation table, that is used to hold the numeric opcode and the action to be taken for the pseudo opcode. So these are the databases. These are the fourth databases. Now the fifth one. So after POT, there may be some symbol table, there may be some literal table. So these are the table used in pass one. First of all, MOT, POT, symbol table, literal table. These are the four table that are very useful during the pass one. Number five, a table, ST. Back. This one is symbol table that is used to store each symbol. With level LABL, not LEVL, level with level and its corresponding value A table ST that is used to store each symbol with level and its corresponding value. This is the table number 5. And the table number 6. Number 6 is a table LT, literal table, that is used to store each literal encountered and its corresponding assigned location and its corresponding assigned location. This location is very important. So these are the table that are used for pass one. And the number seven is copy of input to be used by pass two. So these are the seven databases used in pass one of assembler. First of all, the input source code is the first point. Second point is the location counter that is used to keep track every line. Third one is MOT, that is a machine operation table, and the symbolic numeric and the length of instruction. Pseudo operation table is the fourth point. It is used to hold the pseudo operation and its action to be taken during the pass one. The number five, the symbol table that is used to store symbol value with level and its corresponding value. Last one is literal table. These are the five tables that are used in pass one. Literal table that are used to store each literal encountered and its corresponding assigned location. And the last one is the copy of the input to be used in pass 2. We have to store the copy for the pass 2. So these are the databases used for pass 1 of assembler. Now the flowchart. এবার আমরা যখন ফ্লোচার্ট আসছি ফ্লোচার্ট আঁকার জন্য একটা আমাকে পেজ লাগবে যে পেজে কারণ এই স্পেসের মধ্যে নাও দ্য ফ্লোচার্ট অফ পাস 1 অফ অ্যাসেম্বলার First of all, initialize the source code. This is the start of the pass 1. After the start of the pass 1, we have to read the source code one by one. This is the step 2. After reading the source code, if there is any level question mark, this is the condition, if there is any level, then yes level is yes, then stored level with LC value, location counter value, in ST. Stored level with LC value in ST, and there is a function for this purpose, ST symbol table store. Jokhon stored hoye jabe, then it moves to the process again. So if there is a level, then store the level value, then after storing the value, it will return to the system again. If there is no level, that is go to the, there is no level, then there is a next step, and the next step is search the MOT. MOT mean machine operation table. We have to search the machine operation table. No, we have to search, first of all, we have to search the pseudo operation table first, and after getting pseudo operation table, we have to search the MOT. Search POT. So first of all, we have to search the POT. For the searching purpose, there is a searching code, you know, there is a method, a function, name is POTGET. And we know that every part means pseudo operation table consists of the opcode and the action to be taken. So first of all, we have to search the part mean pseudo operation table. If there is found, mean jeta amra je instruction je opcode amra khuji seta jodi ekhane peye jai, this found, then we have to check the type of the instruction type. If it is DS and DC, I mean declaration statement and declaration constant, if these there is a DC and DS, then determine, we have to determine, we know that these are literal, so we have to determine the length of the data for data space, determine the length of the database required. So you have to determine the length of the database required. So this is the for DS and DC. If the type is DS or DC, if the type is using drop, then it goes to the next scan of next line, then it a next line read korte chole jabe jodi using or drop thake. Or jodi end hoy, amra jani every program end with the end opcode, the end is the opcode to terminate the instruction. If there is a terminate the assembly level instruction, if there is an end opcode is there, then this is a end of the pass 1, that is we have to go to pass 2. Amader pass 2 te jawar shomoy hoyeche karon pass 1 is over, every line is scanned, because prottekta program er sheshe we know there is an end mnemonic to indicate that the end of the assembly level program. For example, this is the end, is the end of the program. So if the operation code is not found in the POT, that is the not found option, then we have to search the MOT. MOT mean machine operation table, and the method is MOTGET. After getting MOT, we have to find the length of instruction. MOT consists of instruction and its corresponding length and the format. So we have to get the length of the instruction and its corresponding format also. Then we have to process the literals. There is a LTSTO function through which we can store the literals. After getting the literals, we have to update the PC. Update the PC mean update location counter, that is the LC value. We have to update, keep track every time LC. When we check there is a DC or DS type, then we have to find the determine the length of the data space required. After getting the length, we have to update the LC again. So LC is the next line formation, this is the next eta through the bujhte pari amra je eta kaj completed amra next line er kaj ta korbo, that's why update LC. And after getting the update LC value, we have to read the next line of code again. So there is a line which goes to the read of next source code. So this is the pass one of assembler. This is a very important diagram. এই ডায়াগ্রামটা তোমরা খাতা থেকে ভিডিও থেকে একবার লিখে নিও এবং পুরো কনসেপ্টটাকে একবার মুখস্থ করে বুঝে নিও, তারপর মুখস্থ করে একবার প্র্যাকটিস করে নিও। এক্সাম এটা প্রচুরবার কোয়েশ্চেনটা আসে, তো এই ফ্লোচার্টটা আরেকবার আমি বোঝাচ্ছি। ফার্স্ট অফ অল ইনিশিয়ালাইজ দ্য সোর্স কোড, ফার্স্ট অফ অল ইউ হ্যাভ টু ইনিশিয়ালাইজ দ্য সোর্স কোড অ্যান্ড রিড দ্য এভরি লাইন। যখনই কোনো লাইন পাবে রিড করবে, দেন ইফ দেয়ার ইজ এনি লেভেল, ইফ লেভেল ইজ ফাউন্ড দেন স্টোর দ্য লেভেল ভ্যালু ইন দ্য উইথ এল সি ভ্যালু ইন দ্য এস টি, দেয়ার ইজ এস টি এস টিও মেথড। After getting the storing the value, then it return back to the system again. Then it search the POT. POT means pseudo operation table. If it is found the operation pseudo, then we have to check the type of instruction. If there is any DS or DC, then determine the length required for the space. And after getting the length, it goes to update LC. After the update LC, it moves to the read of source code again. সো এটাটা আমরা স্টেপ পাচ্ছি, যদি আমরা ইউজিং ড্রপ ইউজিং আর ড্রপ পাই তখন আবার এটা ব্যাক করে রিড করতে চলে যাবে, আর যদি এন্ড পাই দ্যান মিন পাস ওয়ান ইজ ওভার গো টু পাস টু। আর যদি আমরা পিওটি টেবিলটা না পাই, দেয়ার ইজ নট ফাউন্ড অফ ইনস্ট্রাকশন দ্যাট ইজ, দেন উই হ্যাভ টু সার্চ দ্য এমওটি, দেন আফটার গেটিং দ্য এমওটি উই হ্যাভ টু ফাইন্ড দ্য লেন্থ অ্যান্ড প্রসেস লিটারেল অ্যান্ড আপডেট এল সি। সো ডিউরিং দ্য পাস ওয়ান দিস টেবিল আর ক্রিয়েটেড, নাম্বার ওয়ান সিম্বল টেবিল ইজ ক্রিয়েটেড, সিম্বল টেবিল ইজ ক্রিয়েটেড দ্যাট ইজ এস টি টেবিল ইজ ক্রিয়েটেড, নাম্বার টু পিওটি টেবিল ইজ ইউজড, সিউড অপারেশন টেবিল ইজ ইউজ, এমওডি টেবিল ইজ ইউজড, এল টি টেবিল ইজ ক্রিয়েটেড টু প্রসেস দ্য লিটোরিয়ালস। সো দিস টেবিলস আর ভেরি ইউজফুল ডিউরিং দ্য পাস ওয়ান অফ অ্যাসেম্বলার। সো দিস ইজ নোন অ্যাজ ফ্লো চার্ট অফ পাস ওয়ান অ্যাসেম্বলার, ফ্লো চার্ট অফ পাস ওয়ান অফ অ্যাসেম্বলার। সো দিস ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট ডায়াগ্রাম, ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট ডায়াগ্রাম।